Dear students, in today's class, you will learn about the classification of bryophyta. So let's begin. Skimper in 1879, for the first time, gave bryophyta the rank of a division. So Skimper was the person who first gave bryophyta the rank of a division. Remember this. And before that, what happened? The members of bryophyta, they were included artificially among algae, fungi, lichens, mosses, etc. So earlier the bryophyta were considered to be as a member of algae, fungi, etc. But later in 1879, Skimper gave them the rank of a division. The division bryophyta was subdivided into two classes. Okay, so initially there were two classes of bryophyta. Those were Hepatici, also commonly known as liverworts, and Musi, commonly known as mosses. So under Hepatici, there were three orders: Mercantials, Jungamanials, and Anthocerebels. Okay, and under Musi or mosses, there were three orders, that is Phagnales, Andrials, and Bryals. Okay, students. Then what happened? But some other workers also emphasized that the order Anthocerebels, containing Anthoceras and related genera, is sufficiently distinctive from the members of Hepatici, and therefore it should be given the status of a class. So you see, some other workers suggested that the order Anthocerebels, which included the genus Anthoceras and other such genera, okay, so they contain certain characteristics which were quite different from the members of Hepatici. So they requested that, they suggested that Anthocerebels should be given the status of a class, okay? And as such, the order Anthocerebels has been placed in a separate class, Anthocerotae, giving equal rank with that of Hepatici and Musi. So in the beginning, there were two classes, Hepatici and Musi, and later one more class was added to it, which was known as Anthocerotae. Therefore, bryophyta is divided into three classes, namely Hepatici, Anthocerotae, and Musi. Subsequently, what happened? Rottmeller in 1951 and Prosgior in 1957 have changed the class names Hepatici into Hepaticopsida, Anthocerotae into Anthoceratopsida, and Musi, it is mistakenly typed here, Musi into Bryopsida. Okay, so we have got how many classes? Three classes of bryophyta: Hepatici, Anthocerotae, and Musi. Later these names were changed into Hepaticopsida, Anthoceratopsida, and Bryopsida respectively, and these changes were in accord with the International Code of Botanical Nomenclature, that is ICBN. Now the classification adopted by Prosgier in 1957 is as follows. So there will be three classes. We will study each of the class with their distinctive characteristics in details. Okay, so let's see the first class. It is Hepaticopsida. So what are the characteristics of this class? The plant bodies. We know that the bryophytic plant body is a gametophyte. So here it is mentioned that the gametophytes or the plant bodies, these are dorsiventrally differentiated. Okay, that means the body is having a dorsal as well as a ventral surface, and are either simple thallos or with leaf-like appendages. So their body will be a thallus-like simple structure, or they will be having some leaf-like appendages. Okay, so the leaf-like appendages is termed as folios. And what about the internal characteristics? It is internally differentiated into various tissues or not. So there may be internal tissue differentiation or there may not be. Okay, and what are the sex organs are situated on the dorsal side of the plant body. Okay, sporophytes may be simple or with food, seta, and capsule. So the sporophytes may be as simple, or they may contain the distinctive parts, namely food, seta, and capsule. The sporogenous tissue is derived from the endothecium of an embryo. Okay, now this class Hepaticopsida, it includes four orders. Number one, spherocarpals, for example, genus Spherocarpus. Number two order is Mercantials, for example, we will see two genus, Rixia, Mercantia, which are very commonly known bryophyta. Number three order is Jungamanials. So some genera under it are Pelia, Porella, Lejunia, etc. Then number fourth order is Chelobrials. So under this comes a genus known as Chelobria. Okay, students. So now let's move on to the class number two. The class number two is Anthoceratopsida. So what are these plants? How do they look like? The gametophytes are dorsiventrally differentiated. Okay, so they will be also having a dorsal as well as a ventral surface. Their body is thallus-like. Okay. Internal tissue differentiation is absent. Now you know what is thallus like. Thallus like means the body is not differentiated into root, stem and leaves. Okay. Then what happens here in the internal structure? The internal tissue differentiation is absent. That means we can say that internally the plant body is homogeneous. Means all the cells are of same kind. Okay. We will not find any kind of tissue differentiation. So we know that bryophyta contain rhizoids instead of roots. So in Anthoceratopsida, the rhizoids are smooth walled, okay, and the scales are absent. The sex organs in this class are embedded in the gametophytic tissue. So the sex organs, they will be found immersed or embedded in the tissue of the gametophyte. And the sporophytes are differentiated into foot and capsule only. The lower portion of the capsule is meristematic. So here we do not find seta, and instead what happens? The lower portion of the capsule, it is meristematic in nature. Sporogenous tissue is derived from amphitheium of an embryo. Endothecium contributes in the formation of sterile columella. So you can compare one thing, right? In Hepaticopsida, sporogenous tissue, it derived from the endothecium. But in Anthoceratopsida, it is derived from the amphitheium. Okay, and what does the endothecium do? The endothecium has contributed to the formation of a sterile structure known as columella. Now you see the Anthoceratopsida class, it contains only one order which is known as Anthocerotales. And under this single order, there are four genera: Anthoceras, Megaceros, Dendroceros and Nototylus. Okay, students. Now let's see the class number 3, that is Bryopsida or Musi. At first we will see the characteristics. The gametophytes have two stages of development. Okay, so this is a unique characteristic of Bryopsida, unlike the Hepaticopsida and Anthoceratopsida that we have studied just now. Okay, so what happens in Bryopsida? Let's see the two developmental stages. First is the prostrate protonemal stage, and second is an erect gametophore stage. This erect gametophore stage is differentiated into stem-like colloid or axis, leaf-like phylloid and rhizoids. So you have to remember these things, that Bryopsida has two developmental stages. One is the prostrate protonemal stage and second is the erect gametophore stage. The erect gametophore stage is differentiated into three parts: stem-like colloid, known as axis, leaf-like phylloid and rhizoids. The gametophore is the persistent gametophyte which bears sex organs. So out of the protonemal and the gametophore stage, the gametophore stage is the persistent one. Okay, and this structure bears the sexual organs. Rhizoids of gametophores are branched, multicellular and with diagonal cross walls. So this is a distinct property of the rhizoids in Bryopsida. Sex organs are situated superficially, forming a cluster or inflorescence-like at the apex of the stem. So how the in Bryopsida, how the sex organs are situated? They are situated superficially and they form a cluster-like structure at the tip of the stem. Sporophytes are differentiated either into foot and capsule or into foot, seta and capsule. Okay, sporogenous tissue is derived from either endothecium or from amphitheium, but in either cases the sporogenous tissue encircles a sterile columella. Sporogenous tissue not only gives rise to spores, sterile cells, that is elaters, are absent. Okay, sporogenous tissue, they only give rise to the spores, and in this case the sterile cells or elaters are absent. The class Bryopsida is divided into three subclasses, that is Sphagnidae, okay, Andriidae and Bryidae. Sphagnidae contains only one order Sphagnales, and one genus under Sphagnales is Sphagnum. Second subclass is Andreidae. It contains a single order Andreales, okay, and it has some genera. One of them is Andreae or Andrea, you can say. The third subclass is Bryidae. It contains 15 orders, that such as Tetraphidales, Boxbomials, Polytrichales, Dausonials, Dicranials, Pisidentals, Potiales, Grimiales, then Encalyptales, Funereals, Eubryales, Isobryales, Hookerials, Hypnobryales, etc. Okay, so mainly we have studied the how many classes the Bryophyta contain. It has three classes, and each class has a definite number of orders. Okay, Anthoceratopsida class has a single order, and under the different orders we have also seen the name of certain genera. Okay students, so I hope that this video is helpful to you. Okay, then thank you.